My fellow gamers, welcome back to another Pro Guys video. I'm going to be going over the in-depth aiming fundamentals in Fortnite. And I'm not talking about the basics today, guys. No. We're talking about the physics of Fortnite aiming. Who's ready for that? You know, it seems that most of us that got introduced to shooter games with Fortnite struggle with aiming the most. And look, that's normal. You know, developing pro-like aim takes years of training, man, experience, and really just all-around hard work. But if you're aware of a few basics when it comes to sensitivities, you know, aiming styles and practice routines, you're gonna find yourself improving at a much higher rate. So my question for you guys today is, what gun do you have the most trouble aiming with? And before we get into that, aiming's only a part of the whole Fortnite skill set. You know, there's also building, game sense, and map and item knowledge. So many things to learn, you know what I mean? And all that and more. So you should check out ProGuys.com. We've discussed courses going over every subject you need to know if you want to improve. Plus, if you prefer a more hands-on approach, you can play or learn from our coaches 24/7. Make sure you like the video and sub to the channel, then visit ProGuys.com or follow the link in the description to get started. What's going on, guys? It is your motivation guide. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. Listen, I want to let you know right now, if anyone has said anything negative about you, if people have called you names, if people have attacked, you know, your character, or, you know, I want you to be encouraged today to not be moved, to keep going forward. You know, when people have said negative things about me, you know, one of the things that lets me know that I'm doing the right thing is that I have people who are talking about me. And sometimes, you know, when you're on the right path, you're gonna have people come out of the blue and just start talking about you and calling you names, but don't let it phase you, don't let it stop you. It must mean that you're doing something right. So stay focused, continue to be diligent, continue to be consistent, not only in this game, but also in life. Be a leader, be someone that motivates others, that inspires others, no matter what the things people say about you. Forget it, just keep going. Connect with me on my new Insta at Your Motivation Guy. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to sit back, relax, and get my favorite candy. You already know what I'm talking about. It's that Bunch of Crunch, and let's get this going. All right, so if you wanna have good aim, the first thing that you need is the right sensitivity, all right? So let's talk some guidelines on how to set those up and why your current sensitivity might be holding you back. So you might be asking right now, like, you know, I've always heard sensitivity is preference. You know, but that's not really the case. That you can run low, high, or in the middle as long as it suits you. That's true to an extent, but it's generally accepted that lower sensitivity leads to better aim. That's not only Fortnite, but other aim intensive games as well. So why low sens? Well, it allows for a higher degree of precision. Let's think of an extreme example, all right? If there is a really tiny moving target on your screen, like an enemy is 250 meters away from you, how would a crazy high sensitivity perform? Like, if you just cranked every setting to the max? Well, even the smallest movements wouldn't completely change where you're aiming. I'd be next to impossible. It'd be next to impossible to make the precise adjustments needed to be accurate. But if you were to lower things down to a reasonable sensitivity, sure. You know, it'll take more mouse or joystick movement to move your crosshair, but at least you'll land more shots. And that's the general idea behind lower sensitivity. You know, I get that some pro players that use high sens and manage to do exceptionally well for themselves. But even when you look at their gameplay, their biggest downfall seems to be their aim. So, how should you set things up? For keyboard and mouse players, your X and Y sensitivities are going to mainly affect your hip fire and flick shots, your building, and your editing. So you need to arrive at values that you'd be comfortable doing all these with, right? Mostly building and editing, those are crucial. Spend time in creative messing around and just see how long you can get your sens while still performing every move you know comfortably. Like, if you can't build a box around yourself with a single swift movement, that means your sens is too low. And if one swipe of your arm has your character turn around 3 times, then wow, my friends, that's a little bit too high. Finding the middle ground here, guys, is ideally what you want. And on the topic of wrist versus arm aiming, if you exclusively use your wrist to aim, your sensitivity is probably too high. You know, plenty of players think wrist aiming is fine, and if it works, all right, well, more power to you. But based on how a vast majority of pros play, arm aiming is where it's at, my friends. You should only be using your wrist for micro adjustments. You know, I guess you're excused if you have a really small mouse pad, but even then, you're better off buying a large gaming mouse pad so you can start using your whole arm. For controller players, you guys have things like building and editing sensitivities that can always be changed afterward. So your horizontal and vertical look sensitivities are more for hip fire tracking and flick shots. Here, You want to arrive at values that feel enjoyable to use while hip-firing your SMGs and rifles and flicking your shotguns. Then, up the editing and building sensitivity multipliers to find the right speed that helps you build and edit smoothly. So once you're confident with your horizontal and vertical values, you know, it's time to change your targeting sensitivity. Now, there isn't a correct answer here, okay? How you set it up depends largely on preference, but just like before, something lower than the default is typically better. Between 30 and 70% is what we usually see. And if you're on controller, we see that even go lower, between 10 to 20%. You know, it's a lot of variation there, I get it. But as long as you experiment, you're gonna find the value that fits. All right, so what about scope sensitivity? Sorry, controller players. For some reason, Epic didn't add this as an option for you guys. I really apologize, okay? I really do. Hopefully, they pass this right up in the future. But for everybody else, we recommend putting to something slightly higher than your targeting sense. Why? So you can still use snipers at close and medium ranges. If your scope sense is too low, my goodness, you're gonna have plenty of trouble sniping players close by. Then you're never gonna be able to land those nasty quick scope flicks you see pros do all the time. Something just a bit higher than your targeting sense is a decent place to start. Ultimately, it's just your decision what sensitivities you choose. But give it some thought, spend time in creative maps, and don't feel afraid to make adjustments if something feels off. And if you're dying for more info, we're gonna leave a couple of sensitivity videos you can check out in the description below. You always hear about tracking and flicking, the two distinct styles of aim. But what makes someone a tracking legend? And how do you make sure your flicks pack a bigger punch? Well, since your tracking is all about keeping your crosshair on a moving target, it's essential to gain an intuitive understanding of how character models move, like their speed while running or gliding around, and the trajectory followed after a jump. If you know these things like the back of your hand, you could use your enemy's movements against them. This isn't something you should consciously be thinking about though, you know what I mean? It should be more, you know, instinctive. Something that your brain sort of does on its own after just a lot of practice. Of course, you know, you can practice just by playing the game, but to train more efficiently and take it to the next level, come on now, you should hit up some creative maps. Our favorite, and the favorite of a lot of pros, is the classic Dunwozie's Aim Training. This level has a ton of unique courses you can use to work on your crosshair movements and as a way to get used to sensitivity changes. Under the tracking session, we find the best course is Alternating Ranges Long Strafe Zombie Tracking. Man, that was a lot to say. Anyway, just walk in and shoot the difficult you want on the left, then simply fire at the zombie, being sure to keep your crosshair stuck on them as much as possible. But the issue with this map, and a lot of aim maps in general, to be honest, is that the zombies don't mimic realistic player movement. Actual players have different movement patterns, including unpredictable changes that require quick reactions. So to train for that, we recommend with this map, you and a friend, you know, pick a weapon, you know, walk up to the dueling pit and just drop down with the floor edit. Once you touch the ground, you start blasting. Each player has 2000 HP, so there's plenty of health for a long aim training session. Pick the SMG to practice your tracking, but you can also use a shotgun to work on flicks. Speaking of flick shots, just a brief reminder, those are when you utilize muscle memory to rapidly move your crosshair over the enemy for a quick shot. Easy enough, right? Still, oh my goodness, there are a couple of mistakes we see players always make when going for flicks. First, not aiming down sights before a shotgun blast. Now, you don't do this in every single scenario. For instance, if you're literally barrel stuffing your opponent, as in, you know, you're right in their face, aiming down sights won't make a difference in your shotgun damage, but beyond those extremely close distances, you gain a significant amount of extra damage by aiming down sights before you fire. Plus, if you're on a controller, the aim assist you get while ADSing helps out a bunch. For how little effort it takes, you've got to be aiming down sights with every flick shot you can. The second mistake is firing as soon as you flick. All right, so let's just face it, all right? Most of us don't have perfect muscle memory. We don't always end up with our crosshair right on our opponent's head every flick. Sometimes it ends up going too slightly to the side, past their head, or even on their toes. Then you end up doing little to nothing with your shot. Instead of just trusting every flick, like it'll land exactly where you want, it's often helpful to confirm your target before firing. You know, it's sort of like doing two flicks for each shot. One large one to get your crosshair close to the enemy, then a smaller second one that adjusts to their head. It'll only take a fraction of a second to do, and in some cases, can be the difference between you landing a meaty pump shot or dealing a measly hit. You know, the better you get with flicking, the less often you're gonna have to make these adjustments. But it still helps with landing some of the harder shots. So the two creative maps we just showed you are great for training and warming up your flicks. But another favorite of ours is the one you can see on your screen right now, created by Machine Head. It's literally just you against another player in a small building. All the different angles and obstacles you can do, and an excellent job simulating the variety of shots you'll have to take in real engagements. Just remember to work on the two mistakes we talked about. Aim down your sights and go for the head. I thought I'd just chime in a bit on how Bloom works in this game, all right? And I think it's very vital to understand if you want to improve your aim. You know, a lot of newer players think that Bloom is entirely random, as in there is an equal chance that the bullets will go somewhere in the general area of your crosshair while spraying a weapon. But how it works, guys, is that bullets always tend toward the center dot. Even with the full-on spray, if you can get that dot on your opponent, you've got a pretty decent shot of hitting them. This may seem like, duh, Keith Allen, I already know this. But trust us, all right? We see players complain about Bloom all the time, even though in the clips they show their crosshair dot is way off of their opponent. So what I'm really trying to say is that don't just spray and just sort of put your reticle in their general direction. You know, if you want your shots to connect as much as possible, you should hard focus on placing that dot on your target. Believe me, believe Keith Allen, all right? I'm your motivation guy. It can make a gigantic difference in damage. To close things out, we've got a concept that you need to know about called crosshair placement. The idea here is that you should always keep your crosshair in a spot that minimizes the distance it needs to travel. For example, all right, let's just say that you're fighting a player inside of a building. If you walked around with no regard for a crosshair placement, you'd probably be aiming at the floor. Then once the enemy came into view, you would scramble to place your crosshair on them. The chance of missing your shot this way is very high. But if you kept it leveled at head height, pointed near corners where the enemy might pop out of, you might not need to move your crosshair at all. They could literally just walk right into it, and all you have to do is click. I don't know about you, but it sounds like an easy kill for me. And that's the power of proper crosshair placement. Now, in Fortnite, there are gonna be times where, you know, you're gonna have to ignore crosshair placement because, you know, building and editing. Still, there are situations where it comes in handy. Like before confirming an edit, a common trick people do while editing walls is to wait and move their crosshair on the enemy before confirming it open. That way, you know, you could just shoot for the kill. You won't have to go for a wild flick that might miss. Even though it takes a bit of extra effort, it sure does beat editing and whiffing your shot. So while crosshair placement isn't super instrumental or anything like that, all right, you should still try incorporating this into your play, guys. Who knows? Man, it might just help. So to wrap things up, let's go over everything we just learned. First, for sensitivity. Is lower better? Yes. Yes again. For aiming, at least. So you still need to find a balance if you want to build and edit smoothly, okay? Luckily, there are building and editing sensitivities for controllers, and targeting sensitivities all of us can set to truly hone in on our aim. For tracking, it's a smart idea to mix regular aim training with 1v1 duels, okay? Real players move unpredictably, and you've got to know how to react to their movement if you want to have excellent tracking abilities. So spend as much time as you can in aim training, okay? Because practice is the most crucial part of getting better. The map codes we talked about are in the description below if you need them. For shotgun flicks, don't forget to aim down sights before shooting, and don't always trust your flicking abilities, all right? Some angles in this game are pretty hard to accurately flick. Often, you know, it's just better to adjust your crosshair before confirming the shot. Bloom isn't as random as you think. The bullets mostly go toward the dot. If you want to land as many shots as possible, use that to aim in every scenario. And with proper crosshair placement, you can win fights without even having to flick or do anything. So try to keep the crosshair at neck or head level and where you'd expect players to peek. All right, guys, this is your motivation guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. Make sure to connect with me on my new Insta at Your Motivation Guy. Remember that you're leaders. Remember that you're here to inspire people, to motivate people, to be positive, to lift people up, all right? That's what we're here. That's why we're here, and that's what it's all about. Thanks for watching, guys. Be sure to subscribe and hit that bell to get notified for all of our upcoming daily videos. Make sure to leave a comment on which weapons you struggle aiming with the most. And if you'd like to support us even more, you could do that by using code ProGuys in the item shop. All right, guys, we'll see you again next time.